Hi, we're the 97-98 speech class.
During the first half of this school year, we've been learning how to do different types of speeches.
However, this semester, we've been working on something a little different.
Since the middle of January, we have been working on a speech video.
The idea of a speech video is not new here at Sunrise, but this time we've put a more unusual slant on things.
This year, our video is modeled after a variety show.
That's right. It contains everything from skits to songs.
It may sound a little unusual, but we still think that you're in for a big treat.
In the next 30 minutes, you'll see the best and the worst of our speech class.
During the time that we have been working on this project, we have learned a lot about communications and production. Thank Mr. Fitzgerald for all the hard work he has put into pull our project together.
We have had a lot of fun doing this, and we really hope you enjoy our production.
Now sit back, relax, and take in the Heinz 57 variety show.
Thank you. And I'm Joel, and welcome to the Heinz 57 Variety Show.
We have a lot of neat stuff to show you.
Oh, yeah, we do. Let's see, we've got three songs from some of the premier bands and vocalists around.
And we have just
I think it's three.
Three skits?
Yeah. Wait, no. Okay. Yeah. No problem. Yeah, three skits coming up from some very talented actors and a whole bunch of other good stuff. And we just know you're going to enjoy it tonight. Oh, it's going to be great. Oh, my.
Not a sure bright today.
Yeah.
What? What's the matter with this?
I didn't say anything.
You were looking at it.
I'm so sorry. Is it, like, wrong to look at, like,
things,
like, colors around me,
it's
you know?
It's bright, but it's cheery.
Cheery.
Mm-hmm.
Cheery? Yeah.
My knees are stuck.
Oh, here, let me help you, Bert.
Thanks, Molly.
Sure thing.
You always were a peach. Are you like doing anything tonight, Molly?
Oh, I'm just happy sitting and rocking. Why, what do you have in mind?
Forget it.
What you got there?
We were talking about vacation, so I picked up some folders at the travel agency.
Oh, and it's been interesting?
There's a special grand tour for senior citizens.
Where to?
You visit England, France, Belgium, Italy, Spain. Here's the best part, the Mayo Clinic.
That reminds me, we better get our passports in order.
What's wrong with them?
Well, for one thing, they were signed by Ulysses S. Grant.
Hey, Molly. Here's an exciting picture of a couple skin diving in Hawaii. That could be us, underwater.
Why not? We're wrinkled enough. Got there, Bert? Get to some air.
Ooh. You all right?
I'm fine, Bert.
They got some great tours. Look at this, Molly. A 21-day tour of the Greek islands, seeing all of the ancient ruins.
I could stay here and do that.
You're not exactly a new Tishman building yourself. Hey, here's another one. A 10-day cruise of the Caribbean.
No, Bert. I went on an ocean trip when I was a little girl. It took forever to get there.
What? Forever to get there?
Yeah.
Oh, this'll be different. Now all the ships have steam.
Shame they got steam just when you ran out.
Oh, come on, Molly. Say you'll go. I can smell that invigorating sea air.
You'll never make it if it's a 10-day cruise, Bert.
Here's an exciting trip, Molly. An African safari. I can just see myself out there in the jungle, hunting big game.
No, Bert. Where are you gonna get an orthopedic bush jacket?
Say what you want, Molly. I could face the rhino even if it was wounded.
You couldn't face one even if it was stuck.
Why would you say a thing like that?
Because last week you fainted watching an old Tarzan movie.
Don't care what you say, Molly. Just thinking of a vacation. Well, I need a vacation. That remind you of anything?
The Alamo?
Why?
They didn't know when to give up either.
Can't blame a man for thinking young, Molly.
You'll always be young to me, Bert. Hey, is that their music I hear?
I can't hear. My hair aches in the other room.
Well, I think it's music. You want to dance?
Why not?
All right.
If you'll help me up.
Sure thing, Bert. Oh. Come on. Okay.
I'm not an old flame like I used to be.
Sure you are, Bert.
Little rain.
Look, would you quit it with the tree? We have a show we have to do here, okay?
It's raining!
Please.
Did you like that skit?
It was wonderful.
The makeup made them look like monsters.
Well, our production staff would like to apologize for the makeup. Seems that our
they
new
look like monsters!
Our new makeup guy, Arnold, is new with this, okay? I mean, okay. He just doesn't have okay. It quite down yet. But we apologize. It'll be better next week, I promise. Okay,
what's our next thing?
Well, let's see. I think our next thing...
Hyper
the band, that's
and
right.
And who's in the band, Joel?
Which, can I talk, please?
Yes.
Okay. I was just telling you it's one of the premier bands that we have for you tonight. And in it, we have lead vocalist Brian Ramsey.
And Laura Campbell.
Laura Campbell. We have Winnie Chin, and we have Kristen Wells.
And keep an eye on Laura Campbell.
Keep an eye on those things, yes.
Well. Action. One, two, three,
quattro. Thank you.
Isn't that band cool? Do you think I could be a member?
Oh, our next piece is entitled High School Classmates.
Joel, did you like the band?
It was very nice.
It was
nice.
Scary, wasn't it?
Scary?
Yes, they were hyper. Like, really hyper. And Lord, you could see her hair. Oh.
Our next piece, as I said, is High School Classmates, and it involves, let's see, we have Valerie Joy Booth, and we have Julia Marks. Thank you. And we have Luke Brown in his cameo role as the waiter. You'll all enjoy that, I'm very sure. You all right? High School Class.
It's been at least 5 years, hasn't it?
Do you realize that we sat next to each other in every single class?
We certainly did.
We sure were close together, didn't we?
Like a team, we were like partners. I finished the test and you would copy the answers.
Oh, you haven't changed a bit. You're the same cute, mousy little girl I remember.
I guess some people really don't change. I'm sure you're the same on the hair underneath all that.
You're lucky. I can see you haven't added a single ounce anywhere. Come on, can I buy you a cup of coffee, honey?
No, thanks. I'm on my lunch hour, and I have to return some galoshes to the gimbal basement.
If I don't get a cup of coffee, I will never make it to that disaster. Come on.
Well, if it doesn't take too long.
Here's Susie. Have you met him by yourself?
I'm fine, thanks.
Good. No, I think we should have these rails.
That's fine.
Okay.
We can sit on the booth if that chair isn't big enough.
Can we get you close to the ginger ale over here, please?
Alright, coming right up.
So, what have you been up to, Sophia?
I'm working. I have my career.
What do you do?
Literature books, the world of publishers and authors.
Librarian?
Yeah.
How fascinating. Tell me all about it. Some of it.
Hey, ladies,
all right. Oh, thank you. So, let's see. Let me just tell you all about my fabulous marriage.
That must have been a relief to your parents to have gotten you married.
I know. Well, we have a fabulous apartment at 600 Park. Oh, I have some pictures of Bob and the baby. Oh, they're in here. Oh, you've got to see them. Would you like to?
No, thanks.
Oh, well, here.
They're so cute at that age. No hair, no teeth, and so roly-poly.
That's my husband. Don't you recognize him?
Oh, but remember, they voted you the girl most likely to succeed.
Uh-huh. Well, you know what? I will never forget the senior prom. You went with that short, buck-toothed kid. What was his name?
I forget.
How could you forget? He was your brother.
But remember who they crowned as campus queen that night?
No, I don't.
How could you forget? It was your brother.
Oh, you're as funny as ever. I'll never forget how you made all us girls laugh. You were a riot in that gym.
Maybe so, but remember Coach Smith, the biology teacher? He was crazy about me.
Yeah, he had a thing for you and
you, Harriet Selmer. I wasn't crazy about you in high school with your funny colored hair, and I certainly don't like you now.
This may not be the time to ask this, but would you
do me a favor? You've got to be kidding.
Come to dinner Saturday.
Wild horses could not get me into your fabulous apartment.
That's a shame, because a bachelor friend of Bob's coming over, and he's desperate.
What time?
8 o'clock.
I'll be there.
Bye, Sophia.
Bye, Harriet. I'm so glad we met, darling. No, my sweetheart. Ta-ta.
See you Saturday.
Okay.
You're on! Yeah. Hey, come on. Oh, wasn't that great? Oh, that was such a great skit, don't you think?
Did you like it?
Yeah.
I thought Valerie and Julia did a really good job.
Oh, yes. Just friends like
you. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. You want me to introduce our next one?
Go ahead.
Our next one's going to be I'm Cute.
No, you're not.
No!
What? Oh! Hey, what are you
doing?
You're
not either!
What are you talking about?
Anyway, this star music is Tara, Hughes, and all the band members.
Yeah, and, oh, you forgot two other people.
Who?
Brian Ramsey and Luke Brown.
Oh, yeah!
Yeah. So, without further ado, we'll go to Heinz.
You're not cute!
I am too. What are you talking about? Fireside Girls,
fireside?
Isn't it? Fireside, you know, like
fireside?
Fireside,
side.
You know.
Okay, who's starting it?
Let's see.
David Richards, Michelle Fitzgerald, and Katie Spears.
Then why'd you ask me?
Because I just wanted to ask.
That makes a lot of sense, you know?
Do you hear the birds?
Birds.
Mm-hmm.
What about them?
Sorry, sir. I won't tell anyone about that picture I took.
for the picture.
Thank you, sir. $5 to send the fire thrive girls to summer camp. But, sir, $5 will send her to Camp Eddie. How will she ever get back?
Okay, fine, $10. But then I want you to go away!
Sir, certainly!
$10!
Thank you, sir. You've made a fireside girl very happy, and I promise never to tell anyone about this party.
Good! Negative!
$50. $25. $40. $25. $30. Sold. Thank you, sir. You've made a fireside girl very, very happy. And I promise never to bother you again until April 17th. It is the 25th anniversary of the fireside girl, who have always been known for their honesty and good work.
Hey, let me tell you something. I don't want you to ever ring my doorbell again. I don't want you ever to come here again. This is it!
How would you like a candid photo of yourself being a little girl taken by my sister Cecily? Last year, between the two of us, we raised a grand total of $662.17.
Well, there you have it, folks. Fireside Girl.
Yep.
Did strike terror in the hearts of every American, because you know they're
yes,
family.
Yes, I know, Joel.
They're starting at a very young
yes,
age, Nick.
Joel.
What is wrong with you?
Don't you know it's the end of the show again? It's over.
Yeah.
Capisce? Ta-ta! It's over.
Uh-huh.
Isn't that bad?
Oh, please. Okay, I'll cheer you up then. Here's a look at what we've got coming up. Let's see, I think we're having Bill's Banjo Boys come back in to serenade us.
I love Bill's Banjo Boys!
Yeah, let's see, I know.
Coach
Smith? Yeah, Coach Smith.
He's bringing his display of decoupages, isn't he?
All right, yes, we've been wanting to get him on here for about, 3 months now. Yeah, okay, so that's what we've got for you today, folks, and sorry, but our time is up.
No, I got you a present.
Present.
A flower! Wow. Wear it!
Wear it. It's fine.
Joel, I'm sick of your insults. Now when you wear my flower, and why are you looking at my dress that way? I got it at the jail.
At the DAV, you mean?
It was on special.
Yeah, okay, well, whoever let you wear this on the set in the first place, I mean...
Just sign off, Joel!
Please, just don't give me that. Yeah, I will, but if you promise not to wear that dress on here again, okay. Well, folks, this is Joel Mayer. What were you doing? Hey, get off!
This is Jimmy McClaw!
Oh, hey!
You're pulling me around.
Get this off of... Good grief.
Well, that's... Out.
It just ain't happening. One is right, one is left.
your life, your guide, your life and your breath. The fate was ours, still like a song you can't sing. It's about it, just as bad as the spring or a submarine. The fate was ours, like a song you can't sing. It's about it, just as bad.